right, let's take a look at the highlights. First of all, first half yesterday, and Riley Williams is a good quarterback for Oklahoma State, but that cold weather really affected him, and this one gets by Thurman Thomas, and Brian Reffner comes up with an interception, and you have the football in great field position.
That was a big play right there, and here you see Andrew Jackson break one back inside against their very fine defense. We stalled and went for the field goal, and Rick Frank put the first of his three game-winning field goals through the uprights, and we went ahead. We got the ball back again in good field position, and here you saw Marcus Rogers spelling Andrew Jackson, sub for him. Then on the sprint out on a second and long situation, excellent protection for Alex, and he hits Hugh Suffren on the down and out for close to a first down. Here's what was called a slant. The defensive back went up into bump coverage. Hugh Suffren gave him a little inside move and faded it, and Alex laid it up just right. But one of the nicest things about that was the great effort that Hugh Suffren showed. Here on the extra point, Mark, and to show you what a factor the wind was, the wind caught the snap and really made it tough for Alex to field the ball and get it placed down. When they got the ball back, our defense responded again with great play. That was Pop Everett making a big play on the drive that forced them to punt. Again, we got the ball back in good field position, and Andrew Jackson, behind good blocking on a sprint draw play, comes off tackle.
And he played a tremendous game. He played hurt, too, didn't he?
He did. He played hurt, didn't let it bother him. There you saw Dennis Gibson, who led our defense all day long, do a great job of playing off the blocker and making the tackle. And then Jimmy Luber's deflected pass gave us a chance to force them to go for a field goal. And they had the same problems with the win, a bad snap, and we end up keeping them from getting the field goal.
Big play right here, almost intercepted by Randy Richards, and he just came in like a Mack truck on Bobby Riley.
Yeah, he played very, very well, and Terrence Anthony, the other young man, was there that made the play. The field goal was good, and defense comes back again and puts great pressure on Williams, and here's Dennis Gibson with his interception, and we come very, very close to returning this all the way. I told Dennis he's not going to be any sprint champion after watching him run down the sideline here, but we'll take him. We love him anyway. Okay, they force us again to go for a field goal, and here you see Rick Frank again, good on the field goal.
Into the wind.
Yes.
30-yarder.
Good play by our defense. You know, Bill Bertheson and Greg Leiter and Perry Lorries, all three played very well inside at the tackle spot. Gibson on a deflection, and almost got the interception by Terrence Anthony.
Let's go to the highlights now, second half. And first of all, Thomas up the middle, Braswell on the stop.
We had a blitz on there by Anthony Mays and came up just a little short. They had a good line surge, but Braswell made the stop. And here Williams, a good athlete behind a good line surge, and they get in. Okay, at this point, you know, we were concerned about having to punt against the wind. We're doing everything we could to try to control the football, and Andrew Jackson comes up with a big play right here. They were dropping deep to take the crossing routes away from us, and it opened up things underneath. Good protection by our offensive line. That's Keith Sims on their All-American Leslie O'Neill. And here on the down and out to Hugh Suffren. Finally, we stall and have to punt into the wind. And our defense comes back on the field and do a great job of coverage. And Williams has to keep the ball. And it enables Lester Williams to finally end up making the play. After forcing them to punt, here's Andrew Jackson on a sweep play again that breaks back inside. Real nice job of running. And there's a young man that's running with great determination because he's running on a bad leg. Against the wind, though, our players are doing a very good job of controlling the clock. Here on a little slip screen, out to Hugh Suffren. Good blocking there by Dennis Ross. And Hughes needs to go north and south a little bit more with that kind of a pass. But he did a good job of picking up about 6 yards.
Rick Frank had a great day punting the football with and against the wind.
He really did. Here's an example. That's against a very stiff wind. And he had to change his punting motion in order to get a lower drop and kick the ball away from the safety and depend on a bounce. And he really did a fine job.
Wow. All the way down to the 10.
That kept them bottled up against their goal line, even when they had the win in that critical third quarter after that first drive.
Boy, Terrence Anthony would like to have another shot at this one. Look.
Oh, almost. Very, very close. Good coverage. Okay, here's the power play. Nice blocking by the line, and good job of running by Kirk Thomas, our senior fullback.
Boy, he had some great blocks yesterday.
Kirk really played well. You know, the seniors were really fired up and inspired, Mark. Nice job, but Williams threw a nice ball. They just didn't hang on to it. Terrence Anthony again was covering. We come back with a draw to Andrew Jackson again. Finally, when we have the wind at our back here now, Rick really responds with some booming punts.
Oh, giant blast. And Thurman Thomas fumbles the football right here.
Good coverage by our defensive coverage teams, and I'm not sure who that was. It may have been Jeff Dole, who played very well in special teams, as did Randy Richards.
I think it was Breswell. And Lubers with a big fumble recovery, caused by Randy Richards. And Rick Frank, 34-yard field goal. It's good.
Having the win in the fourth quarter with the lead, Mark, really helped. Good, stout defensive play. Here you get a shot of Keith Sims on All-American Leslie O'Neill. They do a good job of covering our receivers, and Alex can't find anyone to go to, so he finally dumps the ball off short to Kirk Thomas again, who picks up positive yardage. After a punt, they've got the ball again, but great pressure by our defense. Jeff Braswell again making the stop.
Watch the whole final possession here. Four consecutive plays.
Lester
three
Williams
sacks
on this one.
Three sacks and an interception.
And that's the way the game went. You know, our defense made the difference in the ball game, and for them to come up with four plays in a row like that was a really tribute to them. This is Dennis Gibson on the screen play. Very well played.
Final play
again
for Oklahoma State.
Williams has an arm. Being covered very well by Terrence Anthony. And Terrence comes up with the interception.
And it's history.